Hey guys, it's Oakley from YouTuber Headlines and welcome back to my channel. Today we're talking about the secrets of YouTube moms. I don't know how to start this video because when I read this yesterday on Instagram, it made me sick. It's disgusting. It's gross. It's horrible. It's what we all know, but no one has said this out loud until now. There's a mommy YouTuber by the name of Haley and Family. She was a teen mom and she's been posting on YouTube for a long time. Just to give you guys a little bit of background on Haley, she is a teen mom. She was 16 when she had her first baby. Haley either applied to be on Teen Mom on MTV or she was approached to be on Teen Mom on MTV. I can't remember which one, but it didn't work out. There was something about the producers, the editing, something about the show that she didn't like, and she didn't go through with it. So she turned down their offer and started making YouTube videos. Just like every other YouTube mom, Haley started to build her social media platform off the back of her child. Some of her most popular videos are all about her kids. She got 5.8 million views on a video she did about her daughter Hazel going to the hospital. And lately she has posted what I eat in the day because she's on a weight loss journey, Costco, grocery haul, what's in my kids' Easter baskets, running errands. This is the type of content she's currently posting on her YouTube channel. Yesterday on Instagram, Haley posted this. Want to hear a secret from a YouTube mom that was in the inner circle at one point? Before I realized they're all batshit crazy. These people love when their children get hurt because the clickbait will really rake in the views. Some even took their kids to the ER just for a thumbnail picture, not because they actually needed to go. I'll let that sit with you. So excited to be closing this chapter of my life. That is the cesspool of YouTube. I think I'm gonna become an anti-family vlogging channel. That will be my new purpose life. Being in therapy has opened my eyes so much to what actually is harmful about sharing your children online. A child should never be the center of your business. A child shouldn't be looked as career booster, even though they are. If your child gets hurt, your first reaction shouldn't be the camera. You need to console them, not worry about the perfect thumbnail. I did send Haley a DM on Instagram. I said, hey, my name's Oakley. I have a commentary drama channel on YouTube. I wanted to reach out to you because I'm going to discuss your comments on YouTube moms on my channel. Do you want to add anything? Also, you said you're leaving that world behind you. What does that mean? Thanks. Haley responded. She said, I think the only thing I can add is just be careful who you support. The best moms on YouTube are the ones with the worst intentions. And she replied again and said, oh, and the whole leaving it all behind is because I'm finally going back to work. I can't express how excited I am. And I said, that's awesome. So no more family vlogs. And she hasn't responded to that message. So it seems like Haley really wants to leave this world behind. And she's been talking about getting a job for a while now. So I'm happy that she was finally able to do that. And I think Haley is going about this the right way. She's not naming names. She is saying her truth. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. So Haley started out by saying, do you want to hear a secret from a YouTube mom that was in the inner circle at one point? So I wanted to show you guys that she did collabs with Karen Swan, Marissa Is a Mommy, Vanessa Christine. So that shows that she did have some type of relationship with other YouTube moms. You guys know all the sick, gross thumbnails that we see of kids on YouTube. With blood on their face, in hospital beds, with tubes connected to their body. Haley said YouTube moms love when their children get hurt because they can use that as clickbait, rake in the views, and some even took their kids to the ER just for thumbnail pictures. This is so sick. This is disgusting. We should not support these channels. I'm sure you guys have seen these thumbnails, but I wanted to show you a few. And I'm not scratching the surface here. There are so many thumbnails just like this on YouTube that shows kids hurt, crying, bleeding. And instead of being consoled, they have them pose for a thumbnail when they're injured. Or they grab the camera and they start filming this child when they're hurt, upset, injured, crying. Because they have to create content. They have to get a picture for a thumbnail so they can clickbait their viewers into watching their video. It's not right. Children should not be used in this manner. Children should not be content. Children should not be taken advantage of this way and exposed this way. As viewers, we've been watching this stuff go down on YouTube for years, and we're tired of seeing this. We will not support these channels that continue to exploit their children and use their children to make money on YouTube and to build their social media platforms. That's what they're doing. They're using their kids to build their social media platforms and to make money. We will no longer support these channels. I'm really upset about this because this is the proof that we've all needed. We all knew this as viewers, right? It's obvious. But for another YouTube mom to come out and say, this is what really happens behind the scenes. This is how YouTube moms think. This is how they create content and thumbnails. This really happens. We're not making this up. This really happens behind the scenes. She said they love when their children get hurt because clickbait rakes in the views and they take their kids to the ER just for a thumbnail picture. How sick is that? Family vloggers, mommy vloggers, daddy vloggers, grandparents who are vloggers need to stop this crap now. Everybody does it. Everybody uses whatever child they have in their life to build their platform on social media, to get clicks and make money. And I don't think anyone thinks about the child, the child's feelings, the child's future, or the online footprint they are creating for their child that never goes away. So we're hearing this information right out of the mouth of a mommy YouTuber, a mom who was friends with other YouTube moms. Haley said she was in the inner circle. I'm sure Haley can't speak for every family vlogging channel and every YouTube mom. That would be impossible. But she is speaking from her own experiences with being in this group, this inner circle with other YouTube moms. If you guys can't tell, I'm a little agitated because I can't stand this stuff. I just can't stand it. So what we need to do as viewers, because really all the power is in your hands, the viewer. Stop watching these videos. I'm not naming one channel specifically because there are thousands of channels on YouTube that exploit their kids and use their kids in clickbait thumbnails when they're injured and have blood on their face. But I'm so glad that Haley is speaking out about this and letting us know the real truth. And this is just the beginning. More YouTubers are going to step up and start talking about this more. I can just feel it. Just remember, your view matters. Think about who you're giving your view to. Every time you watch a video on YouTube, you're putting money in that YouTuber's pocket. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.